Better Business Bureau and the Department of Ag, Trade, and Consumer Protection are receiving an increasing number of complaints of retailers inflating the price of items in high demand right now. Here in the Madison area, Hy-Vee, Piggly Wiggly, Walgreens, and Menards are all accused of price gouging. Those products include toilet paper, hand sanitizer, and meat, among other things. Jamie Perez looked into those items and what the process looks like after a complaint is filed.
In a time of crisis like the situation that we're in now, people expect to be able to go to the store and get what they need at a reasonable price. Things like toilet paper, water, milk, rice, disinfectant wipes. But some people all across the state say they've noticed prices inflate recently. And considering this is a time of crisis, that is illegal in the state of Wisconsin. According to a recent report put out by DACAP, they've received numerous complaints against stores that are price gouging things in high demand right now. Tiffany Schultz, who is the regional director for the Southwest Wisconsin's Better Business Bureau, said not only are items being inflated in their original condition, but people are also breaking down packaging to make even more money.
Somebody breaking up a package of toilet paper and selling it per roll, for example, $6 per roll, which would make a four-roll package $24. Another item that I saw are $2 masks going for $20.
According to Schultz, prices cannot inflate more than 15% of the pre-emergency price unless the store's supplier increases their price. If you notice price gouging happening at a store near you, you can file a complaint with the BBB and DATCAP, who can order them to cease and desist like they've done with several retailers in the state in the past few weeks.
There are people who are losing their jobs left and right. It is illegal in the state of Wisconsin, so it's not fair, it's unethical, it's untrusting. If you're going to price gouge at a time of need, consumers are going to remember that, and they're not going to want to come back and do business with you.
In Madison, Jamie Perez, News 3 Now.
After a complaint is reported, someone from the Better Business Bureau will reach out to the company to follow up. We'll also work with state and federal law enforcement agencies if necessary.